Are you a sports coach, PE teacher, or in recreation? After teaching for over 15 years in these fields and have used many different types of bags over the years, this is the one bag that I stumbled upon through Amazon. What sets it apart? BR1. The nylon fabric is extremely high quality, the gaps are small, but the thickness is good, resulting in a very strong bag. BR2. The size is very large. Do you need to carry 8 basketballs? No problem, I've carried 10 filled to the max. The bag felt fine using the heavy-duty strap. It could probably do at least 12 soccer balls, and as you can see from the picture, a lot of volleyballs. BR3. The drawstring is not cheap like other bags, it is high quality and cinches extremely well the first time, keeping everything in. BR4. The shoulder strap is strongly built into the bag.
While I am satisfied with this mesh bag, I think that some of the reviews may be a little too enthusiastic. It is simply an overgrown mesh bag. I am not sure what heavy duty means in the title, but it is exactly like every other mesh bag I own, just bigger. It has a cord lock, just like every other mesh bag I own. It has a carry strap, which will probably work as long as I do not put more than 5 pounds of gear in the bag, and probably will tear if I do. It has a small zippered pocket, but I cannot imagine what use that would have. Basketball schedule, perhaps? Medium-sized mesh bags sell for around 5 to 10, so I suppose that this large mesh bag is worth around 10 to 15 or so. I paid a little more than that. It would be fine for a collection of very light balls, or snorkel and fins, or plastic beach toys, or other large, bulky, but light sporting equipment. If it were filled with gear that had any weight to it, it would almost certainly fall apart.
I like a quality bag for my uses, and it's bigger than I imagined. I'm going to use it for something other than I intended when I bought it, because there is plenty more space than I figured. I'll buy another one a bit smaller for the original use I intended. I think this will do the job. BRBR update. I use this bag to store 22 large Christmas bulbs we use for are about 10 inches in length and around 7 inches in diameter. They all fit if you've got 23 bulbs. You'll want a second bag. I've enclosed photographs to give you an idea of its size and dimensions. You love it even more now.
Thanks to all the reviews on Amazon, the XL soccer bag was an easy choice. I stuffed a few things into the bag and took off to the gym. There was way more space than I needed. The next time I threw a few more things in. Still plenty of space. Another day, more gear. This thing is enormous. This went on until I was defeated trying to load the kitchen sink in the bag. BRBR anyway. While I was using the bag, I became acquainted with the features. Large drawstring opening with a slide lock. Heavy-duty mesh material that seems to stretch to fit odd-shaped contents. The nylon zippered pocket was a pleasant surprise. Large enough to fit 13-13 lacrosse balls by itself. The shoulder strap is adjustment for a large people and small, large loads and small. Probably the value of this bag is its greatest feature.
I bought a green one of these to store my Outcast flow tube, fins, pump, and accessories. The first thing I noticed was the quality of the netting. It feels thick and seems good quality. And although I didn't notice it when I ordered it, it also has a nice beefy carrying strap. I have a different mesh bag for my other tube that has lasted over 10 years now, so I have some high expectations on this one. But this one seems to be a better design and better materials. Does not feel cheap. Has a nice zippered pouch in the front for additional storage.
Excellent. Love the adjustable carrying strap. I didn't have it full, so shortening it up really made it more comfortable. Love the side pocket zipper for phony keys during practice games. Drawstring, it's strong and has locking cinch clip. It replaced a junky back I bought at Goodwill for about the same price. Wish I had just bought this the first time.
This bag is one I will use for pool exercise equipment. It is a little large for my usual equipment, but can be used for times when I am taking along flippers and other snorkel gear. For my everyday workout equipment, I can also carry my towel and a change of clothing. It is very well made and appears it will be durable. The strap is easy on the shoulder and back. The side pocket will hold keys, swim pass and lots more. I decided to keep it although it is larger than needed because of the quality and price. I think for a travel it can double as a laundry bag, but it takes up virtually no suitcase space.
I have tried several bags from other vendors to keep my coaching gear together when I coach various sports. They pretty much all suck, being the same rough, stiff, Scratchy nylon that hurts my hand as I'm carrying them full of gear. This bag is much bigger and stretchier than the others, has the shoulder strap which is totally worth every penny, and although I thought the zippered pouch would be kind of useless, it has turned out great to keep my whistles, dry erase markers, my small first aid kit in. I can easily fit 7 full-size basketballs in this. I'm going to pick up a couple more so I can keep my basketball, soccer, football gear in their separate bags year-round.
When my bag arrived, the zipper for the side pocket broke on first use. I contacted the seller via message and within hours, if not minutes, was contacted and was shipped an entirely new bag at no cost within 34 days of contacting the seller. The new bag has been working like a champ, no issues with the zipper, and it's holding 910 volleyballs without issues. Love the shoulder strap too. Would highly recommend this bag and seller. The bag really holds a lot. I have 8, size 5 balls, 2 bags of pennies, agility ladders, and a soccer goal net in it. I just wish the drawstring clasp worked a little better. With all that weight in it, it just slowly loosens up until the top of the bag has opened big enough to let a ball through. I've gotten around this by putting a slip knot in the string right behind the clasp, but I don't think I should have to do that.